Welcome to Castleford, a small mining town 13 miles away from Leeds. Lisa Dickinson Gray is 25 years old and a Castleford girl through and through. She's worked in a local chemist for the last 9 years since leaving school.
The lemon fizz shades, thank you.
Over the next month, her life is going to be transformed. Lisa has agreed to be our modern-day Eliza Doolittle. She will undergo extensive training to pass herself off as a lady in London's most snobbish social set.
I'd get on with them. They probably wouldn't talk to me, but I'd talk to anybody, mate, but they probably won't. I don't know, it's nothing, kind of, it's like a bag lady off the street. Or maybe not that bad, but I don't know, I don't think they'd accept me, probably not. But I'll get them.
Tim Walker is the deputy editor of the Daily Mail's Nigel Dempster column, the Bible of High Society. He will be Lisa's guide to the London scene, a world of money and manners where snobbery is still alive.
I chronicle society, I write about it, I know what it is. I know the things she should be doing and the things she shouldn't be doing.
Penny Dyer is the voice coach to the stars. She works with everyone from Nicole Kidman to Dustin Hoffman. She believes that she can change Lisa's accent in a month.
This is a challenge. I think ultimately it's probably the biggest challenge I've faced as yet.
For the last 30 years, Jean Broke Smith has tutored the ladies of posh society in manners and deportment.
If she's the type of girl, which I'm sure she is, that really wants to learn, that wants to improve herself in any case, she's come to the right team.
Is class still alive today? Does it really matter how you hold your glass or the way you speak? In 31 days' time, Lisa will be attending this dinner party of smart movers and shakers in London society. Will the guests be able to tell that she's not one of them?
Are you sure?
Positive.
Do you fancy me in them?
Of course I do. Fancy
you,
don't
me, I put some makeup on. Sort of like...
Lisa has just 1 month to turn herself into a lady of elegance, refinement and class, the very embodiment of aristocratic sophistication.
Come on, I can't go out looking a cow, can I?
Cold.
But for tonight, she can still enjoy being a Yorkshire lass. It's a final night on the tiles with her family and friends before she attempts to enter the hallowed halls of high society and learns the way of the establishment. She'll be swapping lager and pork scratchings for champagne and canapés as she commences battle with the It girls.
And then, like, it come up at 25 to 11, I got to work. It took me about 2 hours to put ours away, and I was just spewing my guts up. And I went up, and I was stood there, like, dispensing, and I had my makeup on the night before. My hair was like this, but I'd just, like, undone them all and tied them off physically.
I groom ladies, sometimes men. I teach them makeup, hair, but my main love is posture. She's got to know how to sit down properly. She's got to know, realise that she can't wave her arms around, put her elbows on the table, shovel her food, etc. All these silly little things, but it's got to be there as a natural thing to do. I can assure you, even the tiniest point, somebody will catch her out, you know, and think, that's not quite right. Where did she come from, etc.?
You've got some stick to come up on, haven't you?
Definitely.
If you start coming talking la-di-da to us, we'll sort you out.
But she'll do it. She's going to do it.
I've never been away from you for more than 2 weeks.
Lisa has never lived outside of Castleford. She comes from a very close family. She married her childhood sweetheart, Chris, 4 years ago.
She doesn't need to breathe. She can just talk for ages and ages. And, like, when we meet new couples, I don't even have to say anything. I can just sit there. She can just talk and talk. People love her.
The look of love is
This is the first time Lisa has ever been parted from Chris. For the next month, Lisa's going to be living with Jean Broke Smith in Holland Park.
Can't disguise
at it, it's lovely.
Hello. Are you Lisa?
I am, yes, you must be Jean.
Well, come in. Oh, Lisa, very pleased to meet you. I'm Jean. This is
Lisa, how are you? Good to see you.
Nice to meet you.
I was thinking whether or not to kiss you, but I think we better get married to the point.
Oh, wonderful. Come in, Lisa.
I've never been away for 4 weeks before, so I didn't know how much to
do. How many shirtless have you got carrying all this stuff?
Gosh, look at the weight of that too. How was your trip?
Brilliant.
And I'm going to get those shoulders back. I can see straight away. And we've got our trainers on there. Yes?
Kind of.
Yes, kind of, yes. Well, be out of there soon. Have you brought some heels with you?
No, I don't wear them.
I'm to some extent, I suppose, your agony uncle, in that I suppose I can teach you basically some of the pitfalls and some of the things you should be looking out for. I'll occasionally say to you irritating things, like you'll say, like, for instance, what would you call that? That there.
Couch.
Yes, you see, I would say sofa. Not because I think saying sofa is better than couch, but I know there are awful people out there who will judge you by things like that.
I'm dying to attack the posture, I really am. I'm dying to, I'd love to, this moment in time, get a pair of scissors out, tidy up her hair, and give her a makeup. Now! Because I can see there's so much potential. She's got a lovely bone structure. It's all there, it just needs to come out. Everything needs to be just chiseled. She just needs the edges sorted out, and in quite a big way.
Don't cross your legs.
You see, you're going to have very sore knees by the time. Whenever I see you crossing your knees like that,
I'm staying somewhere really nice, and this is like posh. And the lady who lives here, Jean, she's lovely, she's posh, and so is Tim, who's going to be looking after me.
Or she might look at somebody and say, gosh, she's very posh.
I would hate to be called posh.
Yes, me too.
And I would hate to know somebody who was posh.
Posh, yes.
Everything that I thought that posh was, yes, I'm here now with it. The old me has got to change, basically. I'm still going to look the same, but everything about me, the way I act, I'm not going to, probably going to interview me in a week's time, and I'm not going to be sat like this. And I won't be talking like this now, so I've met most of it.
We must accept here that the accent she's going to have to lose if she's to be taken as a lady. It's a horrible thing to do and to strip her of that. But you know that she's not going to be taken seriously at these parties with that accent.
I'm in like a couple of million pounds house. Oh, God.
It's Lisa's first night, and she's dining in style at the exclusive Halcyon Hotel.
Thank you. Well, what a day we've had.
Now, would you like to have something to drink while I look at the menu?
Two glasses of champagne, perhaps? What do you think?
Yes, please.
Yeah.
Thank you.
What we're looking at here is a complete minefield. This whole table, everything you do on the table, people judging you all the time by this table. And the first question you always get asked is the aperitif. Champagne is always the best possible reply. Any excuse for champagne, I always recommend.
Wine.
Now, you can tell me your deepest, darkest secret. What do you normally drink if not wine? Alcohol-wise.
Yeah. Beer. Lager.
You see, lager
bottles.
And beer. I had a nasty feeling you were going to say that. That is the most unladylike drink you could ever have in a million years. So
what is the drink then? Champagne and wine?
It's got to be champagne and wine, I suppose.
And what if it wasn't wine and champagne?
Oh,
would you be looking at your spirits and stuff?
You can go into quite exotic drinks. You know, there's nothing wrong for a woman to have, say, a Bloody Mary every now and again. Have you had a Bloody Mary?
Yeah.
It's a lovely, spicy, delicious concoction.
I like Blue Lagoon, actually.
A Blue Lagoon? My God, what's a Blue Lagoon?
It's Blue Cracker. It's that Blue Balls. Vodka.
Yeah.
It's gorgeous.
So long as it's not served with one of those things with a hat coming out of it, or is it?
Well, it depends where you get them from.
Anything with a hat in, I'm afraid, we're going to have to ban you from. I suppose we have it like tea, I imagine, I guess. Okay. Now, this is actually stumped meat. This is a real googly, they're baldest. I think like tea, don't you think, initially?
We'll try. It's really nice. I'm not sure what that is in top.
Is it a leaf of some description?
I'm not eating it.
One of the things.
So am I holding my glass all right?
Oh, fine. Generally, I tend to hold it from the stem simply because it doesn't warm the wine up. Because if you're holding it there, the heat from your fingers is warming the wine up. So I tend to hold it lower down.
And I'm going out of it. Zipping it down.
You said then the most charming thing when he said it, and I said I didn't like the idea of foxes being killed, and you said that's nice, and that's the most charming thing. And in a strange, awful way, that's exactly what we're going to have to stamp out in you, your warmth. Because I suppose a society person would never make a comment like that. Part of our task is to make you a more bland person. I mean, any guy can take you out, and there's never going to be a scene, because basically you never have an opinion on anything. And I wonder.
I don't like the idea of that, though, because basically women do this, ladies do this, they don't have an opinion. And it ain't that. I'm not sure what tea I actually had at James. I think it was herbal.
Now I must watch you on your ages. Herbal.
Herbal.
Say to me herbal.
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 Herbal. Herbal. I dropped it. But I've had a fantastic night. The meal was absolutely unbelievable. And it cost £216. £216! I can't believe it. I can't wait to phone home and tell them.
Hiya.
Lisa, good to
meet
you.
Nice to meet you, Jenny.
Lovely to meet you.
Looking
good.
Thank you
very much. Hi, Tim.
Lisa's first morning and her first voice lesson. Penny Dyer is going to teach Lisa how to speak posh.
Tim has got what you would consider a more posh way of speaking than I have. Because I speak with what's called a general received pronunciation accent. What Tim has is a slightly more advanced, possibly even conservative with a small c, received pronunciation accent, which puts you into a slightly different strata of society. I think what we're looking for you is actually something that sits halfway between me and Tim.
Right.
In other words, I would say A, and Tim would probably say A, and it's ever so slightly shorter as a result. And so we'll work on that sort of thing to start with.
Oh.
E.
E.
Eeyore.
Eeyore.
And give it a really good old massage. And it'll all go back. Lots of massage, that's it. Lovely, lovely. Same with the bottom lip. That's it. Put that in it. That's it.
So in the same way as an athlete has to exercise his body regularly, you know, in order to keep it in trim, you have to do the same thing with all the different facial and speech muscles.
Let's talk a bit like that.
It's a lovely day today.
It's a lovely day, isn't it? What's your room like?
Lovely. It was cold this morning, and it's cold in Castleford as well.
Is it? All right. OK, and then put the lips out the other way as if you're speaking like this. Was it a lot colder than Castleford, you thought?
This morning, yes.
Was it? So what's the weather been like up there recently?
Cold.
Oh, the muscles are working brilliantly. That's fantastic. That's good. Now hold on to your neck.
Wide.
And down.
Down.
To a small hole. A small hole.
Down. To a small hole.
And grin wide. And back to a small hole. Good. Fantastic facial movement.
Is my neck out?
People would die for that facial movement, Lisa. I'm serious. I've had students who couldn't begin to do what you've just done.
Right, Lisa, I'm going to put you into your positioning now. Let's just recheck everything we've done. Head up very tall, but I want that chin back. Tummy straight, all right?
Yes.
But relax the arms and the fingers. Don't tense them at all. Tuck the bottom under. Can you stand on your left leg? Shoulders back. Head up, bottom under, really push that bottom under. All right, let's get our positioning and let's ready and glide. All right, are you in the gliding mood?
I'll try.
Okay, so very gently now, let's go forward, forward. Put your hands behind you if you want to. Okay, and forward, forward. Good girl, good girl. A little bit quicker. Watch your shoulders, watch your head. As soon as I said quicker, this is what happened. Look
forward.
At me.
Okay.
Out. Head up. Okay, that's it. But push it back. Okay. I know you find it difficult. You know, I think she's been so used to doing this.
Yes.
And it's very difficult to teach somebody. It takes a little while. Some people
But by the same token, to have the head up, but at the same time, the eye level. The great thing with this, Lisa, is when you come into a room, before you've even opened your mouth, before you've said anything, you give people the impression that you own the room and that, you know, you have a God-given right, almost.
Hello, Mumsy dear. It's Lady Lisa from London speaking. I'm going out this evening. I'm going to Harpers and Queens. Six and Chocolates. For starters. But just have a look around toilets. Towels. This is for your hands. In a way, I wish you. Take a bloody photo of me. I'm lovely. Me, look at me, look. I'm a supermodel.
Don't move out of the way. Just get one.
My photo taken with Laura Bailey. I think that's her name. No idea who she is, but she's a supermodel anyway. She's just been in toilets. She was really polite in it, and it was strange because everybody went around us, and she seemed to be a bit more like this when our photographers ran. She just came in, she was nice to meet you, and I thought, hello, okay, nice to meet you, and that. I've had a really fantastic time. I really don't want to stay in here too long because the time's ticking on and I want to drink some more champagne because it's free.
I think glamour maybe is something we should give Lisa. Glamour is actually a very good way of dazzling people, to the extent they don't start asking questions about your background and what your father did for a living. This awful English question.
I am a very stylish girl.
Tim has decided that Lisa needs to look the part of a lady and has brought in the girls from Society magazine Harpers and Queen to give Lisa a makeover. Newbie Hands is the health and beauty editor. Lisa will be pampered and groomed until she's gorgeous and fabulous.
But Lisa has never had a manicure in her life.
Very good.
And has got, and it shows, quite frankly.
How do I look?
Very good. I must say I'm amazed.
And what's your favourite shop?
Well, I tend to go to, like, Warehouse, Selfridge.
Fiona Ruby is the fashion editor. It's her job to make Lisa Gucci Pucci and Prada-tastic.
A very stylish girl. How do I look?
Gorgeous.
It's
absolutely gorgeous, darling.
It is so sexy.
Loose and sexy. You look fantastic.
So pretty. It's beautiful.
You look lovely. Lovely. Really, really lovely. That's
no,
the idea of it.
No!
It does not look big.
My bottom.
Sorry, I forgot.
A very stylish girl.
No, just shot £1,000 for an outfit.
It's the opening night of Fosse, a big new musical in the West End. Tim's decided it's time for Lisa to hit London.
So, is this fancy do?
I don't think it is, in a way. Reality is in London, there's no such thing, really, as society do's anymore. Nowadays, everybody's plugging a book or plugging a film or plugging, as they are tonight, a show. And yet the worlds overlap. If you're a society person, you have to come to parties like this. I mean, I've seen people like Sabrina Guinness and, you know, quite significant blue bloods. Chances are they can't afford a do like this. So everybody has to come to these communal events in which you have B, C, D, E, even F list celebrities.
I think it's the first night, yes. So we're really happy. Yeah.
As deputy editor of the social diary for the Daily Mail, Tim's in full schmooze mode on the hunt for stories.
Congratulations on a wonderful performance. Well done, a great performance. It was a wonderful production, absolutely superb. Were you in Fosse? You were in Fosse, weren't you?
No.
Oh, you weren't? Oh, I'm so sorry. Sorry to have troubled you. Sorry.
For Tim, society life is a swirl of parties, free booze and a mountain of canapes as he takes Lisa on his daily hunt for celebrity scalps, slaying them with compliments.
Hello, Glenda. Thanks very much for having me along.
It's hardly a pleasure, thank you.
Wow.
Very nice to meet you.
Hello.
Did you notice that Nigel Dempster described your flavour as last best chance? which I had to get in, because I absolutely believed it.
But in the ugly war for celebrity stories, Lisa finds herself a casualty of fashion.
Now, surely your feet are absolutely freezing, aren't they?
Yes, but they're so much cold.
You can't walk around barefoot in London.
Oh, I'll put them back on.
You've got to put them back on. For heaven's sakes. Have you ever seen Princess Diana?
I don't care. Really. It's my feet.
But have you ever seen Princess Diana coming out of a party?
Oh, God!
But why is it that women wear shoes like that? Is it because of some sort of female code? Or is it because men make you wear things like that, do you think?
Personally, I just don't give a shit what anybody thinks. I think you should be able to wear what you want to wear. I don't care.
Back to the real world, and Lisa's rebelling against her teachers. They wanted to stay in character all the time. But the daily grind of being Lady Lisa is taking its toll.
I have some makeup on, a little bit of lipstick, perhaps a touch of mascara, and...
I've got mascara on.
More.
I'm not going anywhere.
Well, no, but people are seeing you. I'm looking at you this morning. Okay.
And what do you think?
I think you look very pale, and I think you look as if you've just got up.
I am.
Well, I know, but, you know, this is all the code of what you do.
After breakfast, Lisa always has a two-hour voice lesson. To have any chance of getting the accent right, she has to practice every moment she can. It's a full-time job, as she has to completely change the way she talks.
She's learned in the world at the first person who turns shirty.
Fudge. Fudge.
In between the two.
Fudge.
Yeah, so you keep it a little bit more open. Fudge. Keep it more
fudge.
Open. The back of
fudge.
The mouth.
Yeah.
Shirty.
Shirty.
Turns shirty.
Turns shirty.
You go shir. You go to that.
Shirty.
You go to an air almost.
Shirty.
Shir. Shir. Let the
shirty.
Tongue drop right back.
Come to supper on Sunday, Mother.
Supper went very thin.
Supper.
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 Thought we'd have something very casually in the kitchen downstairs.
Fine.
All right, Tim?
Excellent.
Lisa, okay with you?
Yes, fine.
Possibly, can you change?
Yes.
Is that all right?
Fine.
Tim, you're looking extremely smart and elegant as usual. I don't know, what do you think? Just something, a little, I don't know, whatever you feel comfortable in. Something, can we get her in a skirt? Yes.
That's okay.
Whatever you think. She's now got to realise that this is what it's all about.
Yes.
And you can't wear trainers, even... I mean, I have to say, we're just going to have a little kitchen snack.
Yes.
But you can't wear trainers.
I know.
To me, you know, we're not having a very smart dinner. We're just having, you know, a pasta and a chat. But to me, it's rather like somebody coming in with Wellington boots.
I think we've established a rapport with her.
Mm-hmm.
I think she quite likes us, broadly speaking, both
mm-hmm.
of us. And I think now we're going to have to start being tough.
Mm.
And we also have to accept the rather awful thing that it's not a matter of you and I being liked.
You've got to do it all the time.
Yes.
Can I hear a patter of tiny feet? come on, young lady.
Yes, she is.
Much better. Now, walk nicely, please,
yes.
All the way. Well done.
Well done.
Excellent. Oh, you look gorgeous.
Thank
you. There is a certain way, Lisa, of eating asparagus. Yes? Well, I'm just coming over in a minute just to do a quick test.
What would you think, Lisa?
Well, I would personally with the fart, because with the sauce on the plate, you know, you're going to get all sticky
okay,
and...
Well, fork? Knife and fork, or...? Would
well,
you just
it
use
depends.
A fork?
I've never, I don't know. They're quite soft, so I suppose I'd use just a fork.
Yes, but then what, how would you? I mean, would it not?
Well, I mean, I could.
Would it not slip around?
Yes.
Right. And no, none here. There we go.
Yes.
But anyway, I've not had a good day today, at all. There is no place like home. And this lifestyle is not what it's cracked up to be, and people are quite pissing me off around me because
it's just so false, some of it. You don't realise how different things are until you go and live another life. And I've got a fantastic life up north. Up in Castleford, that's my life. And I'm proud of that. And I can't wait to go. Because I'll always be a Yorkshire lass.
Lisa is feeling homesick and has gone home for the weekend.
We're in Castleford. So exciting.
Nice to meet you. Meanwhile, back in London, after 2 weeks, Lisa's teachers are worried that she isn't making enough progress and have called a crisis meeting. Penny's unable to make any real breakthrough with the voice.
In my most optimistic moments before meeting Lisa, I thought, well, yeah, this could be somebody who will go yes and grab it and take it and fly with it. But the hunger really isn't there. Mm. It would take a hell of a long time to educate it, and I'm actually not sure that you can do that. She's 25, going on 18 yes. in some respect.
Yes. She's married somebody. Obviously, it's the first boyfriend, if you like.
Hello, nice to see you.
Miss you.
I miss you as well.
So how do you like it where you're staying?
It's lovely.
Is Jane nice?
Yes.
Yeah. She's looking after you.
She's like another mum, but sometimes I just get a little wound up.
The other thing we need to encourage, and that was what I was thinking, well, OK, we can't achieve, I can't achieve this, so what can I do to help her to achieve?
Yeah.
And it's actually encouraging her to educate herself, mm-hmm. isn't it? To actually yes. to take herself off and visit the art gallery. Because, I mean, that's obviously the sort of thing that I think I would have been doing at 25.
Go on!
If you want to sing happy birthday to Dave Scott.
But does a society really person have to be intelligent? I don't associate in my head a society lady with somebody who's going to be
able to... I don't think it's about intelligence. I think it's about education.
Yes, it is education.
Mother! Shut up. Look what laces yeah, got on! Yeah, Banny shoes!
What shoes? Bagging!
She's used to the cosiness, rather like a cocoon of the North and a cocoon of the family because, you know, she's very close to her family. Which I think is lovely. You know, you cannot get the northern feeling and personality out of her.
What do you think?
Her.
I love
exceedingly strappy.
Oh, she's gonna pull.
Do you think they're £205 worth?
Spirits revived after her visit home, and with 1 week to go, Tim's taking Lisa on a dry run before her final challenge, the dinner party. They're about to enter traditional country high society.
I think the accent, however we play it, is still there. And I don't think we're going to overcome that to the extent that we perhaps thought at the beginning of the project. But it's a matter of being pragmatic now. We've decided that she should indeed come from Castleford, come from a good old farming family up in Castleford, having gone to a school, by implication a private school.
The school that I went, that I schooled at was a girls' school called Airedale in Fairburn.
Yeah.
And I lived on a farm.
Yep, your parents were farmers, right?
Yes.
Tim and Lisa will be spending the weekend in the West Country with Sir Michael Grills and his wife, Lady Sally. They will be helping Lisa perfect her story.
Hello, Lady Sally. Nice to see you.
How are you?
How kind of you to have us to stay. Hi, this is the lovely Lisa.
Hello, Lisa.
Hi, nice to meet you.
Very nice to meet you.
Lovely to see you.
Hello, Michael. Lovely to see you.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Thanks
for a good drive, I hear. Not too bad. Not too bad.
Brilliant. Come in.
Love to see you, Dad. Thank you.
There we go.
Thank you. Thanks so much.
My goodness, what a wonderful spread.
Lisa.
Thank you.
Have a cucumber sandwich.
Thanks very much.
Thank you.
Oh,
thank you,
Sally.
Yeah.
Great.
I wasn't listening.
You were listening.
Lisa's cover story is that her family are landed gentry from a village near Castleford, but to her surprise, Lady Sally's son-in-law works in her hometown.
I cannot believe how small the world is, though, that you've got a daughter in Tadcaster and your son-in-law works in Castleford. That is, yes, it is.
Well, we'll have to get together one of these days.
Yes, definitely. That would be lovely.
It would be great fun. What do you do there? Are you studying?
No, at the moment, I'm just taking time off and keeping my options open at the moment.
But while Lisa struggles to hold her story, Tim shows his mastery of all things country.
What's all this about?
This particular breed of pig is the most intelligent animal after man.
Put it back
in. Sit down.
Sit.
Try and push him down a bit.
He's on her back.
Yes, right. Oh, no. Mustn't let him in there. No. 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 Go away. Shall I shut the door?